President Donald Trump owns more than $122 million in personal real estate, despite also given the opportunity to call the White House home. Even prior to moving in 2017, the mogul already had an array of properties at his disposal. And we filmed this video while President Trump is still the president and the election results aren't in yet, so just in case he doesn't become the president again. Trump loves retreating to Mar-A-Lago in Florida, which has also been nicknamed the Winter White House. And from an NYC penthouse to a St. Martin beachfront estate, he has 8 luxe places currently in his real estate portfolio. Here's a look at a few of them. In these videos, we don't reveal any addresses, and even though I've done a house tour of my own place, please do not show up at any private residences because it's not safe for anyone. Donald John Trump is the 45th president of the United States, and before entering politics, he was a businessman and TV personality, as I'm sure you already know. After attending university, Trump became president of his father's real estate business in 1971, renaming it the Trump Organization and expanding its operations to building or renovating skyscrapers, hotels, casinos, and golf courses. He later started various side ventures as well, even owning the Miss Universe brand of beauty pageants for almost a decade, and producing and hosting The Apprentice from 2003 to 2015. While it was reported that the real estate mogul has outstanding debt on his properties, allegedly amounting to $1 billion, it hasn't stopped him from enjoying them all. According to an ongoing analysis by NBC, President Donald Trump spent more than a year's worth of days at a Trump property since taking office, nearly a third of his presidency thus far. This is none other than his crazy impressive retreat in Florida, Mar-a-Lago, which he clearly prefers over Camp David, the country getaway provided by the White House. Last year, Trump sold his personal property out west, a 5,395 square foot Tudor style mansion in Beverly Hills, for over $13 million, but it still leaves his portfolio with 8 properties spanning 3 states and 1 Caribbean island. And while that's impressive, it's just a fraction of his overall net worth, an estimated $2.1 billion. Hey guys, it's Karen. Today we're bringing you another house tour here in Famous Entertainment. We're noticing a lot of copycat channels popping up, but we're the original house tour connoisseurs, and 95% of you watching aren't subscribed, so hit that subscribe button and ring that bell. We post a new video daily. This is a pretty epic one because today we're gonna look at the properties, well, some of the properties of President Donald Trump. 8 homes are a little bit much to cover in a short video, but we'll look at Mar-a-Lago, his New York City spot, and more. We've all done house tours in the likes of Dr. Phil and Joe Rogan, and we'll link to some at the end. Follow me on Instagram to chat, and as usual, let me know whose house tour is next in those comments down below. And let's get into this video. And foremost, Trump's New York City residence. He lives in the top 3 floors of the Trump Tower here, naturally, and it's a gilded and opulent design 3-level penthouse, 66 stories high, in his skyscraper on 5th Avenue. Trump can enjoy nearly 11,000 sprawling square feet of living space, and his son, Barron, reportedly has a floor all to himself. As you might expect, the penthouse is decorated in over-the-top, lavish fashion, with cathedral ceilings, Corinthian columns, massive sparkling chandeliers, and gold accents throughout. The place just screams luxury, and it was modeled after the Palace of Versailles. Not to mention, it's a piece of pop culture history being featured on Trump's show, The Apprentice. Trump took Forbes on a tour during the last presidential election, boasting that the size was about 33,000 square feet, but he over-exaggerated just a little bit. He had an office on the 26th floor in the building, so living and working here was easy, even a private elevator to reach it. When Trump built the tower in 1983, the landmark skyscraper became one of the most recognizable and greatest in the world. When it was completed, it was the tallest glass building in Manhattan at the time, rising over 600 feet into the city's skyline and sitting on less than an acre of land. Visually striking with its glass curtain wall and sawtooth faceting, its bold bronze exterior is a dramatic architectural masterpiece that has received rave reviews from the New York Times architecture critics. Its interior, with a 100-foot mirrored atrium, 7-foot waterfall, and marbled floors, was also equally impressive. These days, it's said that Trump's massive penthouse here would be worth an estimated $54 million. The next property we're gonna look at is his suburban base, also known as Seven Springs, one of Trump's more under-the-radar residences. In 1996, President Donald Trump purchased a 213-acre property in Bedford, New York, which is about 45 miles north of New York City. He reportedly paid $7.5 million for the property and had plans to turn it into a golf course, but it's remained a private house to this day. He ended up putting a lot of the land under conservation easement after he couldn't acquire zoning permits, according to Forbes. And more recently, after a long battle with the residents and the towns, he finally received approval to subdivide the property and build up to 14 homes. Whether that will actually ever happen is unclear, but the property remains a significant place for the Trump family, said Eric Trump on a recent tour of the 50,000 square foot palatial mansion. And it was the property where the kids spent the summers and weekends. Seven Springs has a massive 60 rooms inside, 15 of which are bedrooms, in addition to amenities like not one but three pools, even one indoor pool that's encased in marble. There are also 12 baths, two servant or staff wings, and a bowling alley. The main house was built in 1919 by former Federal Reserve Chairman and Washington Post publisher Eugene Meyer. He commissioned artisans from Italy to work on the mansion, and we can see an intricately outlined EM for his initials in the ironwork. Outside on the property, there are also features like a barn with stables, hiking trails, and another structure. There's a more modest Tudor-style home, which was built in 1919 by H.J. Hines of Hines Ketchup, a friend of Meyer's. Today, both homes are surrounded primarily by nature preserves, making them almost fully isolated aside from a handful of neighbors who can't be viewed from the houses. Seven Springs is built in a European-influenced design which carries on to the interior. The house is reached through a sweeping driveway beyond maintained lawns to the circle drive in front of the three-level limestone property. An elaborate stone fountain centers the turning circle and a stone portico encloses the main door. Inside, the style retains the grandeur of the outside with marble floors, gilded furnishings, stone staircases, and high molded ceilings. The Georgian windows let in a ton of natural light, giving the place an airy feel as well. There are open fireplaces throughout most of the common rooms, including the wood-paneled library, which seems to have kept most of its original design, including the veined wood panels and inset shelves, delicate ceiling plaster work, and more, along with the addition of some new shimmering gold furnishings. The mansion's current value is more than triple what Trump reportedly paid for it in the 90s, and according to Forbes, it's worth somewhere between $24 to $30 million now. While it's reported that Trump owns homes in Palm Beach, Florida worth a collective $25 million, he loves to stay at Mar-A-Lago, which is also dubbed the Winter White House. All those homes he owns are actually near or surrounding this Trump organization-owned and exclusive Palm Beach resort. The 20-acre estate of Mar-A-Lago has 128 rooms and spans the entire width of the island Palm Beach and is located on, stretching from the Atlantic Ocean to the Intercoastal Waterway. The mansion was built by post-serial heiress Marjorie Meriwether Post in 1927. It spans 62,500 square feet inside and also contains the Mar-a-Lago Club, a members-only club with guest rooms, a spa, and other hotel-style amenities. Mar-a-Lago is the second largest mansion in the state of Florida and the 22nd largest mansion in the United States. In 1985, Trump bought the estate and all of its antique furnishings at a price of around $10 million. He then turned Mar-a-Lago into a private club in 1995 and built a 20,000 square foot ballroom with $7 million in gold leaf. He also spent $100,000 on four gold-plated sinks. Basically, much like his Fifth Avenue penthouse, there's gold everywhere you look. These days, his family maintains private quarters in a separate closed-off area of the house and grounds. In 2019, Mar-a-Lago became the primary residence for Donald and Melania, who previously listed New York City their main home instead. As I mentioned, this seaside resort is often referred to as the Winter White House, and Trump also hosts a number of high-powered visitors and world leaders here as well. While it serves as the Trump family's playground, it's open to people who purchase a membership at the club. Those who are lucky enough to make it inside are treated to a detailed portico that leads into the main building, which features neo-Gothic accents. Once inside, ornate decor, much like a European palace awaits, along with pricey antique furniture. The club's main living room features high ceilings and gold-plated designs over every wall. Because of its flat terrain and open-air access, Trump can fly in on his own helicopter if he's not on Air Force One. And if the club's multiple beaches just aren't enough, you can relax by the various pools on the property, just like Trump and his security team apparently do. In 2018, Forbes estimated the value of the estate at around $160 million, having increased greatly over the years thanks to extensive renovations renovations, lavish features, historic background, and more. Okay, so I think I'll bring this house tour to an end here. We've taken a look at three of Trump's lavish properties, including the famous Winter White House Mar-A-Lago in Florida, his New York City penthouse, and Seven Springs. After seeing these crazy impressive mansions, which was your fave? What did you think about Trump's ornately decorated residences? Be sure to rate them down in the comments. Also, if you guys want to see our brand new studio tour where I film all of these, we'll link you to my personal channel. I'd love it if you guys like and subscribe.
So, Shiro, get off the table, bro.
What do I say? I froze.
Look who's over on the other side. What's Michael like off camera?
Whoa! Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram and let me know which celebrity houses you want to see next. I'll see you all in the next one. Bye!